son in terms of a new relationship through the incarnation. To becoming a man, he had a new relationship with the Father. John 13:16, I say unto you, the servant is not greater than his Lord, neither he that sent greater than he that sent him. I speak not of you all, I know whom I have chosen, but that the scripture may be fulfilled, he that eateth bread with me hath lifted up his heel against me. Hebrews 1 and 5, for unto which of the angels said he at any time, thou art my son, and this day have I begotten thee. And again, I will be to him a father, and he shall be to me a son. Verse 6, and again, when he bringeth the first begotten into the world, he saith, let all the angels of God worship them. In Psalm 2 and 7, I declare the decree, the Lord has said unto me, thou art my son, this day have I begotten thee. 2 Samuel 7:14, I shall be his father, he shall be my son. If you commit iniquities, I will chasten him for the wrong and with the stripes for the children of men. All through the word of God, we have it prophesied and we have it materialized in the New Testament that Jesus Christ is the incarnate word of God made flesh that we might see and know him. In report number 2 on page 75, Christ came to declare the Father, his mission on the earth. Christ could declare the